welcome to the first episode of StockX TV. I'm your host, Josh Luber, founder of StockX. We're coming to you from Detroit, Michigan at the actual desk from SportsCenter. How are we sitting at the SportsCenter desk in Detroit? That's a story for another day, but for now, let's get right into MarketWatch. On today's MarketWatch, we take a look at the last three big Nike releases. First, we start with the Air Jordan 1 Royal, the last of the great OG ones to re-release in the past couple of years. The Jordan 1 Royal has only been released twice since 1985, in 2001 and 2013. This version retailed for $160 and is now selling for $285. The Air Max 1 Master, released on Air Max Day, March the 26th. The Master takes swatches from other Air Maxes that we've seen over the years, combine them all on one shoe. It retailed for $130 and is now selling for $395. And finally, Jordan 4 Cause, a collaboration between Jordan Brand and perhaps one of the most iconic pop culture artists of all time. Cause is best known for his figures, characters, and art that bears the signature XX eyes. Today, the XX replaces the Jumpman on the back of the 4, and the shoe that retailed for $350 is now selling for $1,700. That's enough Market Watch for today. Let's go to portfolios. What if your collection was all Yeezys? What if your collection was one of every Yeezy, and that's it? In our portfolio segment, we take a look at hypothetical sneaker collections and what they'd be worth. If you had one of every Yeezy, you'd have 30 pairs of sneakers. 24 of them would be Adidas and 6 would be Nike. But in terms of value, your collection would be worth $45,000. 53% of that would be Nike. Those 6 Nikes make up more than half of the value of your collection. The most expensive of which, of course, is the Red October, selling for $5,100 right now on StockX. And the most expensive Adidas is the OG 750, selling for about $3,700. Okay, that's enough fantasy collections for one day. Let's get to the feature. In today's feature, we visit Steve Aoki, quite possibly the biggest DJ in the world. I had the pleasure of meeting Steve at Game 7 of the NBA Finals. This is actually us in the locker room holding the trophy after they won. After that, Steve was kind enough to invite us out to his house in Las Vegas, where we got a tour through what is rightfully dubbed Aoki's Playhouse. And Steve has a sneaker collection that is definitely worth seeing. So let's take a look at what's at Steve's house.
What's up, guys? Welcome to my shoe room. When I made this house, I had to find an area to put all my shoes because I had so many shoes stored in boxes in my garage in Los Angeles. Majority of my shoes I have are Adidas. I decided to dedicate majority of these racks over to Adidas. They always hook me up with all the latest exclusives, and I'm also really close with Jeremy Scott, so I could probably say that I have probably the largest Jeremy Scott Adidas collection in the world. Some are just beaten up and worn out because I really did wear the shit out of these guys. Certain ones I don't want to wear because they're too beautiful, and I was like, I'll keep them. And some of them, they're too crazy. Like, I don't know if I could wear these, you know?
It says a lot if you don't know that you can wear them somewhere, right?
Also interesting, because there's like a certain period of time when all I'd want to wear is Bapes. I got the like executive introduction to Bapes. I was in Japan, I met Nigo, I went to his house, and I went with Swiss Beats. We got the full like museum tour of his house. And then the next stop, we went to Nowhere Limited, which is the company that runs Bathing Ape, and he just laced me up. You know, I started hanging out with DJ AM, and he was always hounding me about my Bapes. He's like, yo, you got all those Bapes, and the first thing he did in Japan was like, went to the Bathing Ape store and just bought every single pair of shoes he could buy. Since I wasn't a Nike guy, I didn't really know much about the Jordan culture. We went shopping, he's like, you gotta get a pair of Jordans. So, of course, it's like, you gotta get those. You gotta get those shoes. For me, it's like kind of special. Like the Jordans I have are either the Jordans that I went shopping with AM on or the Jordans that I got from after he passed away, the official AM Jordan sneakers too. In 07, I started working with Supra. We went from this shoe back 10 years ago to doing like collaborations, like limited collabs. This is like obviously the Sky Top. This colorway is the Musca Aoki colorway. This is dirty because I used to wear the fuck out of these shoes, dude. I have some funky ass shoes. Like, this is by June Jae. It's a Korean brand. I got these shoes. I mean, it's like an art piece. I got my Yeezys, got my NMDs. I wore the shit out of these too. I think I wore these to the White House Correspondents' Dinner. You know, you gotta have a pair of those lying around too for moments when you're like standing in the same room as the president, you know?
You didn't think that the gold teddy bears would be good for Obama?
He's such a cool dude. He probably would call these out.
Yeah.
Adidas did, they started this My Adidas campaign. This is around the time when Neon Future 2 came out.
You're working on another album right now, right?
Neon Future 3.
So there's gonna have to be a third pair of those.
Exactly. This is my studio, obviously. So this is where I spend a lot of my time when I'm here. I'm working on music, I'm working on my next album. Throw my shoes off and get to work. And this is the playhouse. I have a CrossFit area to do CrossFit style workouts. Built this mezzanine so I could do cardio, but also doubles as a place to jump off into the foam pit.
How deep is that foam pit?
It's deep enough, man. Josh, you gotta jump in there. Oh!
Thank you very much for letting us see your sneaker collection, your house. This was a lot of fun to come here and to see shoes that anytime, no one else has seen in a long time.
Yeah. Steve has over 400 pairs of shoes, about half Adidas, plenty of variety, and only 6 Jordans. His most valuable are 4 Yeezys and an OG Nike Mag. In total, Aoki's collection is worth over $110,000. But with pairs from DJ AM and Nigo, and at least a dozen super samples with his name on the back, Aoki's collection is priceless.
Okay, that wraps up episode 1 of StockX TV. We hope you enjoyed Aoki's Playhouse and our data-driven view into the sneaker market. Special thanks to our partner HYPEBEAST. And tune in next time as we explore how Kanye has been influenced by America's dairy farmers in the creation of his next shoe.
What are the other shoes here? These are all your shoes. You've worn all of them. Which ones are which?
Nikes, Yeezys, Jordans, and Jordans.
Jordans and Jordans. So they're called the Jordan 3 Black Cement.
Oh, bueno.
Oh, brother. Jordan 3 Black Cement.
See you next time.